Good morning. Welcome to worship with us today. Please know that whoever you are and wherever you are on life's journey, you are welcome here at First Congregational United Church of Christ in Madison, Wisconsin. We are delighted that you chose to be with us today, either in the sanctuary or by live stream. There is Sunday school today, so we will ask that you allow parents to exit first to meet their students. We will then usher by rows. We ask that you remain seated throughout the worship service. During hymns, please enjoy our soloist, only humming if you choose to do so. The worship leaders continue to wear masks in accordance with the Dane County Public Health mask mandate because we do not require proof of vaccination. Today, we celebrate Accessibility Sunday. Much work has been done by our Accessibility Committee and this congregation to be accessible to all. But we remain committed to continue to learn to recognize disabilities and widen our arms of welcome to all. We are grateful to the Reverend Jean Tyler, who shares her personal story with us in the sermon today. Let us now enter our time of worship together.
Please join in our call to worship found on the screen. We gather in the name of our God, the disabled God, the God of access, the God of interdependence, the God whose differences are holy. How shall we worship this God?
With sound and with silence,
with raised hands and with stillness, with words spoken and unspoken, with deep thought and the inner movements of our souls, with every limit and ability of our bodies and minds, we will worship God. Praise be to God. Passing the peace in worship is a gesture that acknowledges our intention to connect with others, offering the divine spark of God's love and peace that is present in each one of us to our neighbor. In that spirit, we say together now as we wave to those around us, may the peace of God be with us all.
Share the Spirit moving among us, weaving in and through this place, breaking down the walls that split and divide, bringing wholeness to embrace. Come, living Spirit, bloom in our hearts as when the
our voices together in the unison prayer of confession. Merciful God, we come before you today as people who are worried about those who are oppressed, marginalized, and forgotten. We confess that sometimes we forget about those made in your image. We confess that we do not speak up when people declare who can be the insiders in our church and our community. Forgive us and create in us a way to keep our hearts, minds, and doors wide open with love and understanding. Help us reach out beyond ourselves and learn about the joys of all the communities. Give us the patience to learn that all people have gifts and abilities to share with our community of faith. We pray in Jesus' name, amen. People of God, the grace of the divine is wide and deep enough for us all. Shed any guilt or shame that holds you back from authentic, loving connections with others. Do not be afraid of your humanity, even when being human means making mistakes, for you are loved more deeply than than you can imagine, and there is nothing that can separate you from the love of God. Amen.
Hello, everybody, and welcome. It's so great to have you here. So today I want to talk about struggles, okay? Things that we struggle with, okay? So think about something that it's really hard for you to do. Maybe you really struggle with reading, okay? For some people, reading is really hard, okay? Some people struggle in maybe soccer or basketball or something like that. And it's really hard for some people to play the game because they struggle and they wish they could kick the ball better or run better, and they can't because they struggle with that. Some people who take piano, they really struggle and just have to work so hard to play the songs, okay? So I want you to think about something that you struggle with, something that you struggle with, okay? And while you're thinking about that, I want to share something I struggled with when I was your age, and I still struggle with it today. I really had a hard time with math, okay? Numbers were not my friends. And especially when I got tired, numbers started switching around. Nines became sixes, and I would hear nine and I would write down a six, or numbers would switch. And they still do that today. And I would really struggle when I was in school with math. I could never, I would fail tests and quizzes because I struggled with those numbers. And I was really struggling with the multiplication table, okay, or chart, and was really struggling. And then along came a teacher who helped me, and she said, "Jeff, look for the patterns in the multiplication chart." And I started looking at it, and I looked at the numbers in a different way, and I said, "Wow, I see the patterns now." Now, I still struggle with the numbers, but it helped me. She helped me to recognize patterns in the numbers and the way the multiplication table was gone. And then I could start looking for patterns in other forms of math to help me find ways to make it work. I still struggle with the numbers, but it helped me in a different way to get to the answer. So I was looking for the patterns. So as you're thinking about your struggles, can you think of ways that somebody has helped you, maybe a parent, or a teacher, or a classmate, or a teammate, you know, said, maybe if you tried this, maybe if you tried that, okay? So people are out there to help us. And we as a faith community, as a church, are encouraged to help other people as well. And that's why I'm coming to you from the pews of First Congregational Church, as you can see in the background, sitting in the pews. And I wanna emphasize something that is in the pews right now. So if you're watching at home on the screen, you stay looking at the screen right now, but I'm going to direct everybody who's in church right now, inside the sanctuary at First Congregational Church, I want you to look down at the floor right now. Yep, that's you. Look down at the floor, and then I want everybody to look left to the end of the pew. And then I want everybody to turn right, look at the floor, to the end of the pew, okay? At the end of each pew, you'll find something, okay? And for those at home, you'll see, I'll put up pictures of that. You'll see there's a brown line. There's a brown tape or something along the edge of each pew. This is a way, that line, okay? That's a way of the people at First Congregational Church working to help other people, okay? So what is that line? What is that line? Okay, inside that line is a special wire, okay? And every section of the pews has a circle of those wires. And what that wire is it's a hearing loop, okay? Hearing loop. And what that does is help people who are struggling to hear, okay? Folks may be sitting in worship and they have a hard time understanding what's being said by the ministers or during prayers and stuff like that. So what that line does, it's a simple line around a circle around each set of the pews. What that does is help people who have a hard time hearing hear better. Okay? They still struggle with their hearing, but it's a way that we can help everybody hear better. All right? So we all have struggles, and we're encouraged to find ways to help others with their struggles, and they will help us. That simple tape line around circling every set of pews at First Congregational Church is a way to help those who are struggling. All right? And I want you to think about other ways that we as a faith community work to help others who are struggling. All right. And I do want to finish with one thing. I recently took an ASL, American Sign Language class, and I wanted to teach you one quick thing, okay? And it's Jesus, okay? You point to your finger to your palm, Jesus, to each palm, Jesus loves you. All right. So just, you know, in case you're wondering, I want you to know Jesus loves you. All right, let's pray. Loving and embracing God. We have struggles in our lives, but we know you are always with us, and we know that you send others to help us. Help us to find a way to make it through with our struggles. Help us to do the same for others. Amen. All right, we'll see you next time.
Our scripture reading today comes from the Old Testament, from the book of Genesis, chapter 32. The same night he got up and took his two wives, his two maids, and his 11 children, and crossed the ford of the Jabbok. He took them and sent them across the stream, and likewise everything that he had. Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him until daybreak. When the man saw that he did not prevail against Jacob, he struck him on the hip socket, and Jacob's hip was put out of joint as he wrestled with him. Then he said, "Let me go, for the day is breaking." But Jacob said, "I will not let you go unless you bless me." So he said to him, "What is your name?" And he said, "Jacob." Then the man said, "You shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel, for you have striven with God and with humans and have prevailed." Then Jacob asked him, "Please tell me your name." But he said, "Why is it that you ask my name?" And there he blessed him. So Jacob called the place Penuel, saying, "For I have seen God face to face, and yet my life is preserved." The sun rose upon him as he passed Peniel, limping because of his hip. Therefore, to this day, the Israelites do not eat the thigh muscle that is on the hip socket, because he struck Jacob on the hip socket at the thigh muscle. May we be blessed by the reading of God's word.
Good morning, church. Today is Accessibility Sunday,
a day when we as a congregation focus on the lives of persons with disabilities as people of faith or not. We recognize all people created in the image of God. We acknowledge the sins of exclusion that have caused great harm for people with disabilities in our churches and in the wider community. We celebrate the progress that has been made by the Disabilities Act, the Accessible Disabilities Act, passed by Congress and signed by President Herbert Walker Bush with United Church of Christ pastor Harold Wilkie by his side. I thank Don, Jeff, and Ann, and the members of the Accessibility Committee for the opportunity to preach with you today. This year, the Accessibility Committee chose to focus on hearing loss. I was an RH baby born with incompatible blood to my mother. This resulted in mild cerebral palsy and unidentified hearing loss. No one knew I had trouble hearing. I was in third grade when everyone in my school was tested for hearing, and I failed that test. I began taking a class on lip reading. A teacher came twice a week for lip reading. I was moved to the front of the room so I could hear and understand my teacher. I was also fitted with a hearing aid. It was a box and a wire and an ear mold. I hated the sounds of paper rustling. 30 students rustling made an awful lot of noise for my hearing aids. I hated being so conspicuous. I was always conspicuous with my walking and my speech and a big hearing aid on my chest. I felt stuck in a world that moved and heard sound. I took the hearing aids off. I put different and much improved hearing aids on again in college after a suicide attempt. In a supportive environment, I began to enjoy the new sounds I was hearing for the first time, like the crackling of a fire in a fireplace, the high notes of a singer, a fuller sound of organ music, especially classical. My hearing aids are my ears. Hearing loops are a gift of technology that has expanded my hearing enormously. I watch TV now, and I understand the spoken words mostly. I like captioning on TV as I hear better when I see the words on the screen. I value sound, but I also value quiet. I do not know what silence is because I hear ringing in my ears most of the time. So what is the good news? The news, the good news, is generosity of spirit, willingness to forgive, and risk-taking. These are biblical bedrocks from which our lives take shape within a world of contrast, experience, and values. My relationship with God has been centered on struggle and gratitude. Struggle has defined my life from the beginning. I struggle to walk, hear, and connect with my family and friends. I struggle to find my place in school. I was terrified of failing life. I was stuck, somewhat like Jacob. A story has been passed down to me from my mother. I was 2 or 3 years old, and I was sitting in the high chair. I was trying to make the food stay on the spoon until I could eat it. Food was everywhere, but little made it to my mouth. My grandma said to my mother, "I will feed Jeannie." I yanked the spoon from my grandma and threw it down. I wanted to feed myself. I struggled to keep the food on my spoon long enough to make the journey from the plate to my mouth. I was thankful for food and grateful for what I accomplished. Struggle was with Jacob as well. Jacob fought with his brother Esau as only brothers can. And then there is a struggle of a lifetime as Jacob encounters a struggle who acts on behalf of God. The stranger gets the best of the fight, which results in an injured Jacob. His hip is displaced, an injury which disables him for life. He is not the man he was. He walks with a limp. Jacob said, I have seen God face to face, and yet my life is preserved. Life is preserved, but transformed. Jacob will no longer walk confidently and gracefully through his life. Rather, he will walk with a limp. I was born blue and rushed to an oxygen incubator. My life changed. Unlike Jacob, I have not seen God face to face, yet I have seen God's people face to face countless times. While I have experienced ostracism by schoolmates and teachers and a few church members whose churches we serve, I have also experienced grace upon grace of acceptance and affirmation and inclusion. I experienced acceptance and affirmation from my pastor growing up and my minister in college, as well as my campus minister. I have at church experienced affirmation for the gifts I offer. You have made a difference in my life. You made the sanctuary and the chapel accessible for not only my hearing aid, but for others who struggle to hear by looping. You have been allies and friends to me. I value your friendship and your commitment to accessibility. I cherish the Accessibility Committee. I cherish this faith that we share, a faith in a still-speaking God whose voice is loud enough and clear enough for me to hear and discern what God would ask of me and of you as well. We are a community gathered around stories of lost and found, disabilities and homeless, compassion and risk-taking. Like Jacob, we too have struggled with God. These holy encounters shape us and mark us as people. Along with Jacob, we find our lives preserved. We find ourselves with disabilities for a short time or a lifetime, and we find the strength to live with them. We find the strength to forgive ourselves and others of the harm caused by hurtful words and actions. We make friends and allies along the way. We discover joy along the way of relationships and accomplishments. Finally, we recognize that our gifts and disabilities are interwoven. Our humanity is revealed in our fierce struggles, our deep joy, and great commitment to engage with God as though our lives depended upon it, as it does. Amen.
Just so that
Let us pray. Merciful God, the story of Jacob shows your willingness to enter into the messiness of our human struggles, into our fractured bodies and relationships, into our family differences, and into difficult situations with people we care deeply about. Each of us has our own gifts and abilities and our own ways of being, doing, and serving in the world. May we see our limitations and our abilities as ways we can reach out with your love and your justice to our neighbors. We pray for all to find accessible resources and a clear path to living a full life. Give us courage to wrestle with the conflicting values, desires, and pressures that confront us so that we can open ourselves to the transforming power of your Holy Spirit. In that power, we pray to receive your love in gratitude and share that love with others, especially those who are struggling. God, open our hearts to the gift of your peace as we give ourselves this time of your presence as we enter into silent prayer. In the example of Jesus and the disciples who followed him, we now join our voices together, praying our common prayer. Our Creator, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Over the years, this congregation has supported the work of making this historic building more accessible. When dealing with older buildings, it is no small task to make changes. But knowing how important it is to be inclusive, this congregation's generosity has spoken volumes. As this work is always ongoing, we welcome however you may be able to share your time, talents, and treasures. Gifts can be made via the website, through Realm, by mail, or at the black boxes near the exits.
We now dedicate our gifts. Generous God, as we love in your name and listen with our hearts, we offer our gifts, along with all of our various abilities, to your work of forgiveness, healing, and acceptance through the ministries of this church. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you.
diverse world, each individual unique in their own abilities and disabilities. Together, we work to make our church accessible to all. We cherish each individual made in the image of God, and we strive to be sure that all our brothers and sisters are able to participate fully in every event we hold in the spaces of our building and have access to all our presentations. Robert Hensel once said, "There is no greater disability in society than the inability to see a person as more." We want to see everyone as a gift from God. Go in peace.